Hi. In this video, we are going to see gate previous year questions with answers for electrical engineering. Power systems, set number 7. In this set, we are going to see 10 different questions from various year. Okay. First question. The reflection coefficient of the transmission line shown in the figure at point P is. Okay. They have drawn the transmission line. In the transmission line, they have mentioned that the value of Z0. Surge impedance is 300 ohms, load impedance is 300 ohms, okay. And here you can see that surge impedance and load impedance are equal. If surge impedance and load impedance are equal, the reflection coefficient will be 0. So answer will be choice C, okay. Reflection coefficient equal to load impedance minus surge impedance divided by load impedance plus surge impedance. In this particular case, both load impedance and surge impedance are equal, so the reflection coefficient will be 0. In other terms, we can say that since the load and surge impedance are equal, the voltage and current waveform are not going to experience any reflection. Okay, since the value of surge impedance and load impedance are equal, the current and voltage waveform will not experience any reflection. Since it will not experience any reflection, the reflection coefficient will be 0. Okay, if sometimes they will be giving the value of surge impedance will be different and load impedance will be different. Okay, in that particular case, you can calculate the reflection coefficient by using this formula. Reflection coefficient equal to load impedance minus surge impedance divided by load impedance plus surge impedance. Okay. Second question. In a lossless radial transmission line with surge impedance loading, okay, takes negative VAR at sending end and 0 VAR at receiving end. Okay, choice B is takes positive VAR at sending end and 0 VAR at receiving end. Okay, has flat voltage profile and unity power factor at all the points along it. Choice D has a sending end voltage higher than the receiving end voltage and unity power factor at the sending end voltage. Surge impedance loading means the load impedance and surge impedance are purely resistive in nature. Okay. In the case of surge impedance loading, since the load impedance and surge impedance are purely resistive in nature, the power factor will be unity, okay, and it will be having a flat voltage profile. So choice C is the right answer. Okay, a lossless radial transmission line with surge impedance loading has a flat voltage profile and unity power factor at all the points in it. Surge impedance loading means the magnitude of voltage throughout the length will be same, okay. And load impedance and line impedance are purely resistive in nature. Since it is purely resistive in nature, the power factor is unity throughout the length. Okay. A lossless radial transmission line with surge impedance loading has a flat voltage profile and unity power factor at all the times. Okay. All the points along it. Next question. The total instantaneous power supplied by the 3-phase AC supply to a balanced RL load is constant. Okay. If it is a balanced RL load, the total instantaneous power supplied will be a constant. It will be having a some value. Okay. The total instantaneous power supplied by a 3-phase AC supply to a balanced RL load is constant. In a 400 kV network, 350 kV is recorded at the 400 kV bus. The reactive power observed by the shunt rated, okay, 50 MVAr. And 400 kV connected at the bus. Okay, they have so mentioned that it is a 400 kV bus. In the 400 kV, they have connected on shunt reactor. Okay, the capacity of shunt reactor is 50 megawatt. Okay, so they have mentioned that in the 400 kV bus, the actual voltage is 350 kV. What will be the reactive power absorbed by the shunt reactor? So from the question, we can understand that the voltage will be. It is given that instead of 400 kV, only 350 kV is there. Okay, so the reactive power observed will be less. So we can directly eliminate 61.73 MVAr and 55.56 MVAr. So the reactive power observed will be less than the rated value. It is less than the 50 megawatt. Okay, so choice A and B you can eliminate. Only C and D. So in order to find out whether C or D, so we can calculate by using a formula. We know that reactive power equal to 3 into V phase into I phase into sin theta, sin phi, sorry. So 3 V phase, I phase, sin 90. So by using this formula, we can calculate that 3 V phase square by X phase. Okay. So by using this, for 400 kV, they have given already the value of Q. Okay, by substituting this, we can calculate the value of reactance. So 3200 ohms. Since the same system you are using, you can substitute this 3200 and 360 kV voltage. Okay, by substituting this, you can get 40.5 mAh. Okay, a three-phase overhead transmission line has its conductors horizontally spaced with the spacing between the adjacent conductors are equal to D. If now the conductors of the line are rearranged to form the equilateral triangle of the sides equal to D, then what will happen to the capacitance and inductance effect? Okay, we can take this as two different cases. Okay, in case one, you can see that it is equilaterally spaced. Okay, in case two, we can see that it is spaced to form a triangle. Okay, in case one, the geometrical mean difference is 1.26 d, and geometrical mean radius is 0.077788 r, and in case two, the geometrical mean difference is d, and geometrical mean radius is equal. So since the geometrical mean difference is dropping here, you can see in that it is 1.26 d and it is only d. Okay, we know that inductance is purely, it is proportional to the logarithm of geometric mean difference, and capacitance is proportional to 1 by logarithm of geometric mean difference. So by seeing this, we can say that the inductance value decreases and capacitance value will increase. Okay, so they have given that in an overhead transmission line, the conductors are horizontally spaced with equal interval D, and the same conductors are placed in the equilateral triangle of distance D. So what will happen to the value of capacitance and inductance? Okay, so we know that the value of GMD is only changing. Okay, so inductance is proportional to the logarithm of geometric mean difference, and capacitance will be proportional to the 1 by logarithm of geometric mean difference. So from this case, we can conclude that the inductance value will decrease and capacitance value will increase. So question number 66. Okay, this particular question is asked in the year 1994. The charging current of 400 kV transmission line is more than that of 220 kV transmission line of same length. Okay, whether it is true or false. The first condition is it is same length. Okay, the transmission line is having same length. Okay, and the voltage is 220 kV and 400 kV. For 400 kV, the higher the voltage, charging current will be more. Okay, this is true. The charging current of 400 kV transmission line is more than that of 220 kV transmission line. Since it is same length, the effect, the value of capacitance will be same. The charging current will increase, be proportional to the voltage. Okay, match the following. So they have given in the list, they have mentioned that improve power factor, reduce the current ripple, increase the power flow in the line, reduce the Ferranti effect. Okay, in the list two, they have mentioned that shunt reactor, shunt capacitor, series capacitor, series reactor. Okay, generally the purpose of shunt capacitor is to improve the voltage profile and improves the power factor. So shunt capacitor will improve the power factor. Okay, so from this we can see that improve the power factor A will match to the choice number 2, that is shunt capacitor. The purpose of series reactor is it will smoothen the waveform. Actually, it will the ripples it will be removing. So series reactor will remove the ripples and create a smoothened waveform. Okay, series capacitor, the purpose of series capacitor is actually it will reduce the overall reactance. Okay, so power flow is proportional to the 1 by reactance. So series capacitor will increase the power flow. Okay, for increasing the power flow, we use series capacitor, shunt reactor. The purpose of shunt reactor is if the transmission line is not loaded, okay, very lightly loaded condition, okay, because of the capacitance effect, the receiving end voltage will be higher than the sending end voltage. This effect is normally called the Ferranti effect. Okay, Ferranti effect says that the receiving end voltage will be higher than the sending end voltage. Okay, the higher value so purely because of the effect of capacitance in the transmission system. Because of the effect of the capacitance in the transmission system, the receiving end voltage will be slightly higher. Okay, it will damage the insulators. In order to avoid the damage of the insulator, we use shunt reactor. This shunt reactor will reduce the voltage. Okay, so choice B is the right answer. Okay, again I am repeating, the purpose of shunt capacitors is it will improve the power factor. So in order to improve the power factor, we use shunt capacitor. Okay, the purpose of series reactor is it will reduce the ripple content of the system. It will smoothen the waveform. For smoothening the waveform, we use series reactor. Okay, the purpose of series capacitor is it will reduce the overall impedance of the system, overall reactance of the system. If the overall reactance of the system is reduced, it will allow easier flow of the power. So more power flow can be transmitted. Okay, the purpose of shunt reactor is to avoid the failure of insulator during the overvoltage. Okay, when the transmission line is underloaded or lightly loaded condition, the receiving end voltage will be higher than the sending end voltage. This effect is called the Ferranti effect. Because of the Ferranti effect, insulator get failed. Okay, in order to avoid the failure of insulator, in order to to nullify the effect of capacitance, we use a shunt reactor. Okay, a cable has the following characteristics. They have given the value of inductor and capacitor. They have asked you to find the wave propagation through the cable. So they have asked you to find the velocity of wave propagation through the cable. So we can calculate the velocity of wave propagation is 1 by root of LC. Okay, we know the value of L, we know the value of C. By substituting the value, you can get the answer. Okay, here you have to observe the unit. So they have in the question paper, they have given the unit is wrongly. Okay, 159.24 meter per microsecond. Okay, the micro is not given. Okay, so choice D is the right answer. So they have in a cable, they have given the value of L and C. They asked you to find out the velocity of wave propagation through the cable. So it can be found by 1 by root of LC. So by substituting the value of L and C, you can get the answer. Shunt reactors are sometimes used in high voltage transmission line. Okay, so what is the purpose of using shunt reactor in high voltage transmission line? So as we already seen, to limit the over voltage at light load or heavily light load. Okay, light load, this is called as I already explained, it's a Ferranti effect. Okay, at light load condition, because of the capacitance effect, the receiving end voltage will be higher than the sending end voltage. Because of the higher voltage, the insulation will get damaged. Okay, to avoid the damage of insulator, we use shunt reactors. In a load flow analysis, the load connected at the bus is represented by, generally in a load flow analysis, load connected by a bus will be represented by constant real and reactive power. Okay, in a load flow analysis, the load connected at the bus is represented by constant real and reactive power from the bus. Okay, the bus to which load is connected is known as load bus, and load bus real and active powers are specified. Voltage magnitude and phase angle to be found. Okay, so in a load flow analysis, they will be giving two values. They will ask you to find out other two values. So in this particular case, they have given the real and active power, and we have to find out the voltage magnitude and phase angle by using load flow equation. Okay, thanks for listening. If you have any specific doubt about this question or previous six set, you please ask us. Okay, all the best for your exam. Thank you.